All right, we're now joined by Commodore Jay Tariela. Sir, good morning to you.
Good morning, Ms. Karen, and also to your viewers.
All right, so if was it specifically the Chinese Coast Guard ordering the Filipino fishermen to return the seashells they've gathered in the West Philippine Sea within our exclusive economic zone?
Yes, Ms. Karen, it was the Chinese Coast Guard personnel who harassed and drove away the Filipino fishermen. But before they were even allowed to leave the vicinity of Bajo de Masinlo, they were first instructed to return the seashells that they gathered before leaving.
Okay, at ginawa yun ng ating mga mangingisda.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, so what do you make of this incident? Because clearly the Chinese Coast Guard is taking ownership of the area. They are, in effect, they're operating and running the area.
Well, on the part of the Philippine Coast Guard, ma'am, that's our role to make sure that all this kind of aggressive and harassment of the Chinese Coast Guard will be documented and then will be presented to the National Task Force West Philippine Sea. As the first step that we did, we located source of the video that was circulating online, and we asked him to sign an affidavit and also to look for the other fishermen who also experienced the same harassment on the day that the Chinese Coast Guard started harassing those Filipino fishermen who are gathering seashells. So after we have completed the investigation report, we are going to forward this to the National Task Force West Philippine Sea and for the concerned government agencies to take action. It is worth noting that the Department of Foreign Affairs is a part of the NTF-WPS, Ms. Karen.
Okay. Now, this transparency policy, right? The transparency policy in the West Philippine Sea has, of course, informed more Filipinos of just the aggression and the state of what's really happening there. But the bigger question is, what do we do about it? We report it. Of course, you have the records, you report it. But at the end of the day, on a day-to-day level, the Chinese Coast Guard is there, right? It's there. So where are we? I'm just curious, all right? I mean, at the end of the day, fishermen will go there and the Chinese Coast Guard is there. Are we there?
Well, Ms. Karen, if we're just talking about Bajo de Masinlo, no? We obviously, right after the Scarborough Shoal standoff, we totally lost control of Bajo de Masinlo. Since 2012 until now, it passing through three presidential administrations from the time President Aquino, President Duterte, now President Bongbong Marcos. It is already an open book that the Chinese Coast Guard has a complete control of Bajo de Masinlo. Now, the approach of this current administration, besides from the Transparency Initiative, is to It was very clear that the president has given his specific instruction to the Philippine Coast Guard and to the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources that despite the presence and the effective control of the Chinese Coast Guard in maintaining Chinese Coast Guard deployment in the area, we also have to deploy our own vessels to make sure that we are going to protect the welfare of the Filipino fishermen. But in this particular incident, that there are no Coast Guard assets or even BFAR assets that were there, I have to be very honest with you. It is a result of the rotational deployment for us to optimize the presence of our Coast Guard vessel. At this point forward, we are reaching out to the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources that our presence should be supplemented by the BFAR vessel. In those instances that our Coast Guard vessels will be in other areas of the West Philippine Sea patrolling, we are hoping that the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources can be able to deploy their vessels on those times that we're not there. And also, at the same time, if BFAR will not have vessels to deploy there, the Coast Guard will still be there. Now, your question, Ms. Karen, are we just going to continue doing this patrolling?
But you said something I feel that is quite important and has moved the conversation forward today is clearly the Coast Guard, the Chinese Coast Guard. You said they have complete control and physically they are always there. Tama, no? They
yes,
are always there. In other words, for lack of a better word, they're parked there.
Basically, they are patrolling there.
Exactly. Patrolling there, parked there, possibly they just, it's rotational. So if one vessel leaves, another one replaces it immediately.
Yes.
So maganda ang punto nyo, napaka-practical. Dapat tayo rin, may ganun, may kapalit.
Yes. And Ms. Karen, this is also the first time, no, during the time President Marcos, that it was only last year that we came so close, no, to Bajo de Masinloc during the BFAR and the Coast Guard deployment of our assets. It's not true that we have just allowed the Chinese to take control of it. Under this administration, at the same time that they are deploying their vessels, the Philippine government is also deploying our government vessels.
Uh-oh. Palagay niyo ba, Commodore, if let's say there was a Philippine vessel there, whether it was the Coast Guard or BFAR, na nandun din at that time, do you believe the Chinese Coast Guard could have treated the Filipino fishermen that way, ordered them to return what they have harvested, or do you believe it could have taken on a different turn? Maybe they could have just ignored the fishermen.
I think, Ms. Karen, it would have been a different story. Based on our experience and engagement with the Filipino fishermen while the Chinese Coast Guard are there, they are always thankful that the Philippine Coast Guard or BFAR vessel is in Bajo de Masinloc, because they even reported to us that if we are there, then the Chinese Coast Guard will not board their vessel, will not get their catches, or will not even bother them. No, the Chinese Coast Guard will just primarily focus their attention on the Philippine Coast Guard and the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources vessel. So it means that whenever we're there, they are neglected. The attention is on us.
Yeah. So technically, if we really want to exercise, right, jurisdiction, ownership of territory when it comes to that area, there has to be a system, right, of rotation. It has to be scheduled. It has to be intentional on the part of this government. It can't be na pag nawala ang Coast Guard, hindi nyo alam sinong papalit. Or pag alis nyo, wala pang kapalit. So ngayon, wala pang ganung plano, Commodore. Because you just brought it up now on Head Start.
Well Ms. Karen, no? The only reason why we brought it up right now is because, unfortunately, there was really a lapse on the part that there is no BFAR that was there to cover the absence of the Philippine Coast Guard vessel. But I think this will already be operationalized in the next coming months, considering that since we started this transparency and maintaining our presence in the West Philippine Sea, it was only this time, Ms. Karen, that another harassment has ever happened to the Filipino fishermen. Since last year and now, ngayon lang naman tayo uli nakarinig ng ganitong uri ng harassment with the Chinese Coast Guard. Eh.
So I want to thank you so much for the information that you shared today. I think it's practical. It makes perfect sense. And it allows us to actually move forward with this conversation. So I always want to thank you for being on Head Start, Commodore J. Tariela of the Philippine Coast Guard. God bless you, sir, and all the work that all of you do.
Thank you, Ms. Karen, and you can always count on the Philippine Coast Guard and the national government to maintain our presence in the West Philippine Sea.
Thank you very much, sir.